Hey guys, what's going on? Today we're going to be doing a video on Lord Slug and the Giant Category Leap. So overall, we're going to be doing, three separate videos. We're going to be doing one for Lord Slug, which is going to be today's video. Tomorrow, we're going to do the weekly grind, though tomorrow's weekly grind is going to be global only. I decided to go and start doing my weekly grind videos. Every other week is going to be a different version. So tomorrow's is going to be the global side. The following Wednesday is going to be JP, and then so on and so forth, because there's a lot of repeated material there. And things typically change every couple weeks, not every week. So that way it could split everything up. Next day, I think on Thursday, I will be doing the LR Bardock team building guide. And then I'm going to go over the Namekian category lead and the free-to-play event, because I figured, you know, it's pretty simple of what you need to do. They highlight the cards for you that you need to do to grind out the event. Just in case new players want some more information, that should probably be on Friday. I am also going to do either like a 2 or 3 video overview of Dragon Ball Legends, so that will be released over the weekend as well. So anyway, without further ado, let's go ahead and jump into this video. This is going to be the video about Lord Slug, the dreaded Super Namekian. Actually, we want to go over his SSR variant first. So this is going to be Greatness Reborn Slug. This is from the Lord Slug movie. Leader ability is Physical Type Ki +2, HP Attack and Defense +50%, Super Attack Darkness Eye Beam, causes extreme damage to the enemy and greatly lowers defense. His passive skill, Lord of the Universe, attack and defense +70%, and additional attack +40% for 5 turns while receiving an attack. So he will not have a 40% buff until he's attacked, and then once he's attacked, he will have that additional 40% buff, which is 110% attack for 5 turns total. Link skills are Metamorphosis, Namekians, Big Bad Bosses, Thirst for Conquest, and Nightmare. Categories are Movie Bosses and Namekians. He has max stats of HP of 6400, attack of 6764, and defense of 3136 with a 12 key multiplier of 135%. His super attack can be farmed. His super attack comes from the Budding Evil Power Slug. We're not going to go over him yet. This is going to be for Friday's video. But this card is going to be farmable from this event. It's Super Saiyan Goku, which is the false Super Saiyan form. I know it's, I think it's Kaioken over here, but it's like the false Super Saiyan look. But anyway, he's going to be available from Stage 2, Star That Has Closed the Light. You're going to go ahead and you're going to farm that out, bring the Namekian category with you. We'll be doing a full guide on the Namekian category lead, but he is the actual leader for the category. Ki +3, HP attack and defense +50%. And essentially, it's just any Namekian in-game you can throw on there. LR Piccolo, any of the other Piccolos, Demon King Piccolo, Demon King or Piccolo Junior Giant form, the other Piccolo, Kami, so essentially almost anything, and Nail. The higher the rarity, the higher the drop rate increase it's going to be. But yeah, he goes and he is going to Dokkan Awakened with 20 medals. These are the 20 medals that you're going to get. These medals are going to also be available from this event at Super Saiyan Goku. Those medals are going to be available on level 5, Evil Namekian Warrior, !! He will Dokkan Awakened into the dreaded Super Namekian Slug Giant, so he can link with himself. His leader ability is Giant Category Ki +3, HP attack and defense +120%, which is alright, you know, that's cool. I mean, Giant Category, I don't really run too much, but they do have some decent units, though not a lot, or I don't think any of them have immense damage. But he also does Extreme Physical Type, HP attack and defense +70%. Super Attack Darkness Eye Beam, supreme damage to the enemy, greatly lowers defense. Passive skill, Legendary Super Namekian, which is actually really awesome. I wish Dragon Ball series actually dove deeper into the Legendary Super Namekian, because I feel like Piccolo deserves some new type of transformation, and they could have totally used this. I know it's not canon, I know, so all the people yelling, not canon, I get it. But still, it would have been awesome if Toriyama actually did something with that. Anyway, passive skill, Legendary Super Namekian, attack and defense +80%, additional attack +50% for 5 turns after receiving an attack, medium chance to turn giant up to 2 times. Now, I feel like they should have increased that to like 10 turns or 7 turns or something like that. 5 turns, even though it's still good, I mean, I don't know when you're really going to run a full giant team, but it's just meh for me anyway. Link skills are Metamorphosis, Namekians, Big Bad Bosses, Thirst for Conquest, Nightmare, Shattering the Limit, and Transform. So we gain 2 Transform and Shattering the Limit. Categories are Movie Bosses, Giant, and Namekian. Max stats are going to be HP of 9134, Attack of 8344, and Defense of 4351. Max stats are going to be HP of 11134, Attack of 10344, and Defense of 6351. And max stats, if you get all dupe system unlocked, is 14,534 HP, attack of 13,344, and defense of 8,951. He has a 12 key multiplier of 140%. His additional 50% is calculated separately for total boost of 170% for 5 turns after receiving an attack once per battle. Support units passive skills would be added to the initial calculation of attack plus 80%, meaning that, okay, also additional, okay, cool. So that additional 50 comes afterwards. That actually makes it a little bit better. I guess it's not 130. I'm assuming his Undokon variant means the same. Yeah, it will mean the same thing for him. So that's pretty cool. I personally don't really see myself ever running a giant category lead. I think they are cool. Maybe they would be good for Super Battle Road, especially if you have something like the Tapion for HP attack and defense, or was it whatever? Yeah, is it HP attack and defense plus 150%? I think that would be really freaking awesome. But yeah, that's what that is about, and it's pretty cool. I'm not gonna lie to you. I kind of like the category. I like what they're doing with it. Yeah, the Tapion is HP attack and defense plus 150%. In terms of giant category lead, Tapion obviously is better. But if you don't have Tapion, and my team building guide is assuming you don't have Tapion, Lord Slug is going to be your leader. The other thing is Tapion only does giant category. He doesn't also include extreme like agility type or something like that. So you got that. He also has that going for him, where you can bring extreme physical types. That's in the Mechian category for something else. So over here we have our team building guides. Let's go over to our Dokkan Battle Builder view. So we have Lord Slug over here, and his best linking buddies is all the guys he will link with in the game. Doesn't matter what category they're from or what team they're from. As you see over here, they're all extreme units. I did not plan it that way. That's just who he links with. His best linking buddy, obviously, is himself. The two of them are themselves. The Undokon variant of this card, which is the physical Lord Slug, not the giant form. He has Metamorphosis, Namek, Big Bad Bosses, Thirst for Conquest, and Nightmare. And it's the same thing over here for his technique one. It's the same exact link skill set. The cool thing about this is he gets a 10%. HP regeneration when he's linked with himself, so that's really good. 10% is a lot, especially if you have like a Tapion team and you bring the two of them together, because they're going to be healing a lot. I mean, think about 150%, that's 300% HP buff. With a 300% HP buff, imagine that alongside a 10% attack buff. That's just a lot of HP. Big Bad Bosses is going to come into play every once in a while when your HP drops because of his transformation and Namek Saga or Namekian regeneration. Maybe you won't hit that as much, but when it does, you're going to get an 80% attack buff and a defensive buff of 25%, which is cool. And they both share Thirst for Conquest and Nightmare, so you'll have at least, 25% going off and 10% HP recovery. And if you're below 80%, you get the additional attack and defense plus 25% up. So that's cool. He links with the technique Turles, which is pretty good. Big Bad Bosses, Thirst for Conquest, Shattering the Limit, and Nightmare. So he's going to have at least 25% attack buff and 2 key, which is really awesome. You have Metarildo, which really doesn't, he hasn't had a Dokkening or anything like that still. But Transformation, Big Bad Bosses, Thirst for Conquest, and Nightmare. So he gets a little bit of everything with them. Korra, the Agility Korra, Final Form. Transformation again, Metamorphosis is freaking awesome. I love how a lot of these guys have the Metamorphosis link. Big Bad Bosses, Thirst for Conquest, and Nightmares, and the same thing with the Baby Vegeta, which is the same thing except he has Breaking the Limit and he has Metamorphosis. So honestly, out of all of his best linking buddies, I'm probably going to say that this Vegeta over here may be the best one for him, because even though he doesn't have Big Bad Bosses, he has the key, which no one else has. He actually hits off the HP regeneration. Let me retract that statement. Other than linking with himself, this is probably going to be the best. Just because himself, like linking with himself, he doesn't give himself key, and that kind of sucks, but 10% HP regeneration, you could definitely work around that, especially with support items, or support units as well. But he has 2 key, 25% attack buff all the time, and HP regeneration of 5%. So overall, I'm definitely going to put him on the top tier list. He's just missing, 5% HP regeneration, so he might be one of the best linking buddies for him. Which is pretty cool, considering the fact that he's free to play. So that's awesome. In terms of monophysical extreme, or actually it's really monophysical, I'm just putting everyone on here. So you have for extreme, Korra is going to be the best linking buddy for him. It's because he shares Metamorphosis, which is 5% HP regeneration, Big Bad Bosses, and Thirst for Conquest. So that's cool. You have Goku Black over here with 2 key, which is Big Bad Bosses, or 2 key, 2 link skills, and Nightmare. You have Rebrand, and Rebrand it does have the transformation thing going on for her, so that's awesome. HP, 5% HP regeneration and Shattering the Limit. Piccolo on here, it's just physical, so we're not really worrying about his leader ability in this case, just who he's going to link with on this team. So Piccolo for two link skills, Goku with two link skills, and Majin Buu for two link skills. So honestly, he really doesn't fit that well on a mono physical team, maybe with Korra as Korra lead if you don't have anyone else to link with Korra. But this is for two or more, he has three link skills with him. And HP regeneration, Big Bad Bosses, and Thirst for Conquest is not bad. He just shares no key links, which you really want for Korra because you want those super attacks. But that's him with the mono physical team. Then we have the Namekian Saga. Now, in the Namekian Saga, there's really like not that many options you have here. I'm pretty sure like you need every single Namekian in-game in order to make a full team anyway. But for Namekian Saga, obviously, like we already talked about, he's going to link with himself. You have Evil King Piccolo or Demon King Piccolo over here for three link skills, which is Thirst for Conquest, Break, Shattering the Limit, and Nightmare. You have Piccolo Jr. Giant Form, which is three skills as well, Big Bad Boss, Shattering the Limit, and Huge. You have Elder King Piccolo or Demon King Piccolo Old. That's going to be, he is a support unit, so that's pretty awesome, Shattering the Limit and Nightmare. Not so much, you're probably gonna, on a Namekian team, he's going to be a good support unit. Let's see, what does he do? The enemy's entire attack, he reduces the enemy's attack by 25%. So he's not going to really do anything for this actual Namekian Saga anyway at support. You're not going to really run him on, well, you will run him on a team, but not primary, most likely. Regular Piccolo, the physical Piccolo, who is really old, at defense plus 70% for all allies, which is pretty good for a defensive buff. Two link skills over here, Namek and Breaking, Shattering the Limit. You have regular Piccolo over, well, these are also, right, this is also regular Piccolo, which is Namek and Shattering the Limit as well. These two are SSRs. I just had to keep them on here because of these two that were up over here. So you could just ignore these because these are the SSR variants of the two I already talked about. Overall, if you're going to run them on your team, which you probably will on Namek Saga, just because you want that 120 TUR on your buffs when you're running things that require the Namek Saga, you're probably going to want to link him with himself. If you don't have two of the Dokkan variants, use his free-to-play form. If not, Demon King Piccolo is going to be your best bet for link skills, and Giant King Piccolo, because the two of them, that's a 4-key and Big Bad Bosses, and this is 2-key and 25%. So honestly, I think Demon King Piccolo is probably going to be your best bet because he has a consistent attack buff, and he does keep plus 3 attack plus 25% up, so he's going to be making sure with his passive alone, you're going to have 9-key and attack plus 25% up on top of that. So honestly, for a Namekian team, if you don't want to grind out the free-to-play one, this Demon King Piccolo is going to be good. Or if you did grind out the free-to-play one and you're looking for one to link with your friend, when you're running double of these guys, this Piccolo might be very well suited for the job as well. Anyway, let's actually see. That's probably two instead of three. It's not that great, but still, it's nice attack buffs. Plus, remember his passive with the key and attack buff. Anyway, next one is going to be Big Bad Bosses, or the Movie Bosses villains team. Who does he link well with? Well, Turles, for one. Turles is probably one of his best linking buddies on this team. I didn't translate this one to English. So, Turles, Technique Turles, Big Bad Bosses, A Thirst for Conquest, Shattering the Limit, and Nightmares. That's actually really good, 25% attack buff, 2-key, and Big Bad Bosses when HP is 80% or below. There's no Metamorphosis, which kind of stinks, but at the same time, you know when your HP goes below 80%, they're going to get that additional attack and defense plus 25% up, which is cool. You do have the Technique, or the Intelligence Turles for 3-key, which passive skill, 3 link skills, passive is 3-key to everyone on the field when HP is 50% or above. So that's pretty cool. So he's going to get 5-key total as long as your HP is over 50%. The one thing that's kind of wacky about that is the most benefit you're going to have is when your HP is between 50 to 80% because you're going to get Big Bad Bosses. You're going to get his passive of 3-key to everyone. And then you're also going to have Shattering the Limit for 2-key and Thirst for Conquest for 15% attack buff. I don't really think that having him here is going to be your best bet on this team. Maybe if you run him as a support unit, maybe not as a primary linking buddy, that would be a good idea. But if you have the Tech Turles, that's probably going to be a better choice for you to run since he has 4-key links on this team. Another one is going to be the Korra. I mean, both of these Korras are really good. They both share 3 link skills, HP recovery for transformation, metamorphosis, Big Bad Bosses, and Thirst for Conquest. So that's pretty cool. It's the same one for the Technique type. It's transformation, Big Bad Bosses, Thirst for Conquest. You have the OG Korra over here, but he's more of a support unit anyway. But if you do put him in the middle, he will hit off Thirst for Conquest, Nightmare, and Shattering the Limit for 2 key. The two Janembas that are over here, which is really awesome. Transformation, Big Bad Boss is a Nightmare. I'm pretty sure that's like almost the same thing across the board. Yeah, Shattering the Limit, though, instead of Big Bad Bosses. So that's something to take into consideration there. Boom, boom, boom. Transformation, Shattering the Limit, and Nightmare. LR Bojack on this team. 3 Link skills. Big Bad Bosses, Thirst for Conquest, and Shattering the Limit, which is pretty cool. I'm not going to go over the Intelligence Bojack. Yeah, they're pretty much all the same at this point now. So you have a lot to link with. He does do pretty decently on this team. I don't know, in terms of team building, we're not going to do a team building guide alongside of him. But if you're going to run him on the team, at least you now know who he will link the best with. Personally, I would run him alongside the Tecturlus just because that's probably going to be your best bet in terms of getting link skills off. Plus, his passive 7 turns from the start of the turn, key plus 3, attack and defense plus 60% up. While it's not the best passive in the game, it is still something that is not horrible because you give himself a defensive buff. So you can go along with that. Otherwise, LR Bojack's also a good one. But if you have LR Bojack, you could run any of the other 2 Bojack or 3 Bojacks if you happen to pull 2 of them, which will give him better link skills anyway. In terms of the Great Apes team, for 3 or more link skills, the Piccolo, Giant Piccolo, not Great Apes team, I guess it's Giant team. Giant team is Piccolo. You have the Baby Vegeta 2, or Super Baby 2. Turles, Giant Turles, you have Raditz, and you have Vegeta. Now, honestly, out of all these guys, I mean, I think that, like, Raditz is probably the only one here who is not, like, top choice for me, anyway, to run on the same team. Piccolo's cool because he reduces enemies' attack and defense by 20%, medium chance to stun the enemy. So he's cool, you can have him there. He has Namekian Link skill. Actually, he doesn't have Namekian Link skill. He has Big Bad Boss's Shattering Limit. And huge. So he's still good because he will reduce the amount of damage that's done. These 3 are probably going to be the best for attack damage. I'm actually have the wiki over here. By the way, shout out to the wiki and dbz.space and Dokkan Battle Builder because all awesome information as always. Vegeta has attack and defense plus 80% on his passive when HP is 80% or below. So Vegeta's going to be lower on the list, but he does have a nice passive when it kicks in. Turles is key plus 3, attack plus 90% when key is 9 or more, which is freaking phenomenal considering you're going to be starting with 6 key anyway, and he has 2 key. You're always going to be getting it off when they're linked together. And then Baby, which I know is his passive skill is attack plus 100% when performing a super attack, or when HP is 30% or above, may turn into Great Ape. So honestly, these 2 are going to be the best to link with overall on a Giant team. So if you're going to run a Giant's team, you're probably going to want to have at least one of those 2 on the team so that way you can run it together. Yeah, that's pretty much it for that. I guess the only other thing you can take into consideration is his extreme physical form. He links with 5 link skills. He won't be getting the 120% buff. Also, again, remember, guys, as I stated earlier in the video, this is not including Tapion. But 5 link skill or 5 link skills over here if you happen to pull 2 of them. Other than that, if you don't have him, then you're going to run these 2 as your primary linking buddies. In terms of a best team, I mean, honestly, over here we can go over, let me go ahead and add his SSR variant, just so that we could have him in here. This is going to be his best linking buddy for 5 link skills. We're going to assume you don't have 2 of them, that you only have 1 of him, because most of us are probably not going, we're probably going to want to feed into the dupe path anyway, the dupe system. If not, I mean, I don't know how I feel about it. Keeping a second one instead of using the dupe system. I feel like you should do the bottom right dupe path first because he's farmable. And then if you pull another one, then use him for linking. But I don't know. I haven't looked at the Reddit for damage output, whether bottom right dupe path is going to be better. Plus, you have to take in consideration who else you have to run on your team and how much damage that they're going to do. As we talked about, these 2 are really good linking buddies for him, which they actually are going to be linking with each other on my team. But that's what they are here for. So in terms of the Giant category, Fasha's over here as a pseudo support unit because she does change intelligence. I believe it's intelligence to strength. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's intelligence to strength. So that's cool. You do have Goku over here, Goku GT, Golden Big Giant 8, who is an amazing support unit overall. In terms of for Lord Slug, his best 2 linking buddies are going to be the Giant King Piccolo. For 3 links, which we already talked about, it's going to be pretty cool. Big Bad Bosses, Shattering Limit, and Huge. So they will almost always be getting super attacks off that figure. 6 key total plus 4, 10 key. So you only need 2 more to get off super attacks between the 2 of them. Rebrand is another second that you could run. Now, I'm not a big fan of Rebrand. I can't stand her. She's really annoying. but she does have attack and defense plus 80% when performing a super attack. Ki plus one when ki is raised with ki spheres. Ki plus one per ki sphere, so she's always getting attacks off. Chance to turn giant 2 times. So she shares 2 link skills with him, which, I mean, really isn't the best, but transformation, shattering the limit. So she's almost always going to have her super going off anyway, plus she gives the HP regeneration. So those are going to be 2. Obviously, like I said before, the baby Vegeta or the Turles are going to be the 2 best links to link with him. If you only have 1 of them, link with him. If not, and you have both of them, these 2 link very well together. Big Bad Bosses, Thirst for Conquest, Fierce Battle, I believe it is. Yeah, Fierce Battle and Saiyan Roar. So, I mean, that's 30%, 40, 55%, plus the 25, 67. They're like 70, what, 80%? Buff, let me get out the calculator really quick. So, they have a ridiculous amount of links over here. Actually, I could probably just do it in my head. 25, 30, 40, 55, 65, 75, 80%. Yeah, dude, that's 80% attack. I can't believe that. Plus, if his Goku's on the field with his passive skill, that's 80%. And then his 33%, that's, dude, it's 110% just from having the 3 of them on the field at the same time. And then you also have to take into consideration their passive skills, 100%. For the baby Vegeta, and then 90% for the Turles. And the Turles gives himself 3 ki, so actually, since he gives himself 3 ki, you don't need him in the middle. You can put him here, and if you have Goku there, he's getting 2 ki from GT, so he's going to have 8 ki instead of 6 ki. So that's probably going to be a really better move for you, because they're just going to be ridiculously OP. On top of that, then you also have the Turles and the Vegeta. They link very, very well together as well. Battle Ethic Saiyan or Saiyan Warrior Race still sucks. Attack plus 7 per 100. They need to fix that up. But they give each other 4 ki and 25% attack buff with Saiyan Roar. Plus, Turles is really good for his attack buffs. So you can go ahead and link him there if you want to. Really up to you on how you want to do it. I think Vegeta is a little bit subpar. Honestly, this is probably going to be better setup over here. If I had my choice, assuming I don't have his other SSR variant, I'm probably going to take her out of the team. I'm probably going to have these two to link well together, and then it's going to be one of these two. Even though Piccolo, Giant Piccolo, shares an additional link skill, it's Big Bad Bosses, Shadow Limit, and Huge. You have Turles over here, which is Shadow Limit and Huge, but he does more damage than that Piccolo. So, I mean, it's really up to you on how you really want to run the team. I just think it's a really good setup that you have. I mean, all enemies, attack and defense minus 20% is great and everything, but yeah, that's probably what I'm going to go with, because you're going to get more damage output with these two linked together, and even though he is not the crazy good linking with him, they at least will always get super attacks off. But anyway, yeah, that's pretty much it. I'm probably going to go with that, and then obviously you're going to have your other Lord Slug, which I'm just gonna use this guy on rotation, just because why not? Use the most powerful Lord Slug on your primary rotation, and that's about it. But that's my idea of a good guide for this, guys. What do you guys think? How is your team? Do you plan on running this? Obviously, again, this is meant to be without Tapion, so if you're looking for a guy with Tapion, I'm pretty sure I already did a team building guide with him. But anyway, guys, thank you for joining me here today. Catch you down in the comments below, and I hope you guys, if you want to get him, I hope you pulled him. All right, good luck on your summons. Peace out.